Tithal, or the Lamb of Beauty. Nepal is one of the best destinations for tourists in the world. It is a mine of natural, cultural, and adventure tourism. Pokhara, the headquarter of Western Development Region of Nepal. Pokhara is considered as the capital city of tourism. The location of the city and surrounding topography has played prominent role to make the city famous all over the world. Tithal is one of the adjoining villages with Pokhara, and it is enriched with the panoramic view of mountains and green hills around. It lies in the northern part from Pokhara and has spread between 1040 to 1963 meters height from the sea level. The village is adjoined to Dhampus Village Development Area in the west, Luanghalil Village Development Area in the north, Riban and Lahachuk Village Development Areas in the east, and Hamza of Pokhara Sub-Metropolitan City in the south. Visitors can arrive the village traveling along a 15-kilometer motorable road, out of which 10-kilometer is blacktopped and the rest is gravelled. Similarly, the visitors can easily access the village on foot from different entry trails linked with Pokhara Baglung Highway. From Milanchok, Suinkhet, Paskorchok, and Fedi, one can reach the village in about 30 to 45 minutes on walking. The village seems to be a part of the heaven ascended on the earth. Visitors can enjoy looking the view of Annapurna and Dhaulagiri mountain range from every house in the village. The fishtail Machapuchre peak seems so close that the visitors may feel as if they can touch it with their fingers. The marvelous scene of the sunrise and sunset also allures both the domestic and foreign visitors. The village consists of some beautiful small hamlets such as Astam, Nuagaon, Tanagaon, Pindawari, Gairagaon, Thuldunga, Hemzakot, Tital Saunepani, Dadali, Okhri, Hadaule, respectively from east to west. The cultural composition and the natural beauty of the village has attracted film shooters. The village has been identified as one of the best places film visualization by Nepal Film Development Board as well. Regarding the name of the village, there are several myths in the local communities. One of the myths tells that there was a huge lake at the bottom of the hills, extended from Lumre to Samibagar, and the village is named after the lake. Literally, "the" in Gurung and Tamang languages means house and "tal" means lake. The combination of the two words in one, "thital," therefore meant village nearby lake. There were some residents with their surname Thital in the village many years ago. The people later on fled to eastern part of Nepal due to some unknown reasons. However, their surname became the name of the village. The village has remarkable cultural characteristics. People from different communities are found to have been living harmoniously. Ethnic communities such as Brahmins, Kshatriyas, Gurung, Tamang, Magar, Bhujil, Sunar, Damai, Kami, Sarki, and others have been historical residents with social harmony and peace. All the people of different caste and ethnicity have cordial relationship. They borrow, lend, share, gather, and participate in every social activity as per the need. The local but traditional music band Naumati Baja has been famous among the people of Pokhara region. Of course, it refers to the fact that the village is rich with cultural phenomena. Most of the people in this village follow Hinduism and Buddhism. Although there are some people having inclination to other religions as well. The people show deep respect to others' faith and creeds. Some of the popular religious sites are Bhumisthan, Koilikot, Kalikasthan, Baraha Temple and Shivalaya, Falle Dada. The Panchamukhi, literally five faces, Lord Shiva's idol in Falle Dada Shivalaya Temple resembles to the idol of Lord Shiva in Pasupati, Kathmandu. Therefore, the villagers believe that Shivaji Temple had been built concurrently with Pasupati Temple of Kathmandu. The Bhumisthan temple is located on hilltop of the village, and the local people involved in worshipping of the Bhumi god every year. Some individuals offer a special sacrifice of he god, expecting grace of the god for a certain wish. It is still in practice that only males are allowed to eat the meat of the sacrificed god in the temple. Females are strictly restricted to any form of worshipping the god in the temple. Moreover, some people vow to offer the sacrifice of 5 animals, that means Panchabali, to Koilikot on the 9th day of the 10-day long Dasaim festival. On the day, local people organize a grand procession with Panchabaza, the local musical band, and march to the temple, expecting their wishes to be fulfilled by the Lord. Such a worshipping tradition is accomplished with similar or slightly different fashion at different temples and religious sites in the village. Some people in the village do worship summon gods such as Chakri, Bhair, and Nag or snakes with deep faith and devotion inherited from unknown past. Religious, ritual, and cultural practices in the village are liberal. Everyone is free to observe his/her festival, culture, and rituals. Local women observe this festival for 3 days by organizing various programs such as singing, dancing, and sharing their feelings when they gather at a pavilion in each locality. Women involved in different culture-specific activities on different occasions, like sewing lakhi dance in Tij. Thank you. singing Vailo in Tihar, Asari songs in Asar, playing with colors in Fagu Purnima, etc. The major festivals of the villagers are Dasain, Tihar, Losar, Thonthe, Janai Purnima, Maghe Sankranti, and Chaitya Dasain, which are celebrated in a number of ways. Sacrifice of animals at such occasions in the name of God has been significantly decreasing due to the awareness campaigns conducted by animal rights activists. Majority of the people adopt agriculture as their main occupation. Paddy, wheat, maize, millet, and oat are the major crops. Likewise, the main cash crop are mustard, potato, yam, garlic, onion, chili, tomato, etc. Recently, some people are attracted to the plantation of tea and cardamom as cash crop. Paddy farming in the month of Asad, that means June, July, is considered to be the major farm work, which is mostly accomplished in team of neighbors. The dal is also familiar to many neighboring villagers as the village of animal husbandry and vegetable farming. The farming is still in the traditional practice, and if modern skills and technology is applied, it can be good occupation for the villagers. The need is there to transform the subsistence farming to professional one. Along with agriculture and husbandry, some surveys have indicated that the Dal village development area along with Thampus and Luanghalel village development areas can do much better in medicinal herbs. Another yielding sector can be the freshwater fishery in Idi and Mardi river banks. Recently, local people have set up a vegetable collection center and a milk chilling plant at Vindabari in order to boost up agriculture and animal husbandry. Nevertheless, the youth of this village have a growing trend of getting into cities like Pokhara and Kathmandu for a job and other opportunities. Similarly, a significant number of youth is in foreign employment, particularly in Gulf country Malaysia, Korea, Japan, and in European and American countries. In education, there had been a tradition of teaching children, particularly male, through Gurukul system. The practice of living in teachers' or gurus' residence. With modernization, villagers started setting up schools. The first school, Bhumeshwar Primary, was established in 2017 BS. Currently, there is one higher secondary school, one secondary, 9 primary schools and one private boarding school in the village. Besides, Baraha Technical Institute, established in 2057 BS, has been providing diploma level education in livestock. A primary health center was first established in the village in 2031 BS. Now it has been extended to the Vidavari area health center. Therefore, the center has been providing health services to the people from Dital, Luanghalel and Rivan village development areas. In case of some complicated health problems, the villagers go to Pokhara, Kathmandu, Chitwan for further diagnosis and treatment. In the early days, the villagers had obligation of relaying public information and notices from a katwal or messenger who often used to speak as loud as he can from a hilltop to the social residents. At present, public information is shared through individuals by modern communication medias such as FM radios, cell phones, television and newspapers. None of the villagers seems to be unaware of modern tools and technology. As this village development area is full of hilly landscape, it frequently faces the problem of drinking water and irrigation. Although efforts have not been enough, some steps have been taken to solve the problem of drinking water by collecting water from polythene pipe into a reservoir and distributing to individual households. If the government and non-government sectors pay proper attention and sincere efforts, the problem would be solved because there are sufficient drinking water resources in and adjoining villages. Another factor of public concern in the village is the transport. All wards of the village have a connection to the major gravel road. The two main entry points to the village road are Milanchok and Fedi on the Bupi-Sercan highway. When the gravel road is blacktopped, the village would be changed into a much easily accessible touristic destination from Pokhara. The urgency for it is high, but the efforts have been low. Enriched by cultural and natural heritage, Tithal deserves very high potentiality for tourism and hospitality business. The visitors can watch beautiful mountain view of snow peaks such as Machapuchre and Annapurna in the northern side from all the places of the village. Virtually, the visitors can quench their thirst of embracing and kissing their mountains by visiting the village. Since it has been the destination of both domestic and foreign visitors, the village has started homestay tourism service at different communities. All sorts of visitors can enjoy relatively better service at cheap price from local residents. Besides, there are some modern hotels at Astam. The village is also mostly visited as start or end point of Machapuchre Modal Trek, Mardi Himal Trek and Annapurna Base Camp routes. The trekkers do feel really deserve to have arrived in the village. Likewise, the village is potential for paragliding jumps. Ecotourism, rafting along Mardi River in rainy season and other adventurous tourism events. Mineral water industry is another potential business sector in the village, for there are several pure water resources with all mineral components essential for drinking water in the lower part of the hills. Furthermore, the village can be developed as a favorite picnic spot for city dwellers, particularly of Pokhara, which adjoins the village. Considering all these facts, people who live in the village and those who have attachment and responsibility for its progress are humbly requested to pay sincere attention to the development of the village and contribute for its prosperity. Both government and non-government organizations are expected to work jointly with concrete plans for the environment-friendly development projects. JICA has assisted the village for drinking water collection and purification tanks at different places. Similarly, CHESS Nepal, Nepal Red Cross Society, Community Development Fund, and local level women network are adding some bricks on the overall development of the village. All the concerned individuals and organizations therefore need to contribute as much as they can to pursue domestic and international tourists to visit the village and provide them warm and heartily hospitality. The young generation, instead of wandering in foreign lands for jobs, has to work hard to generate job opportunities by setting up business industries in the potential sectors of the area. Individual as well as collective efforts are needed to materialize the dreams. If sincerely exercised, the future of the villagers would be brighter and more prosperous. Developing a village elsewhere does contribute to building the nation in general. Therefore, let's make a collective effort to develop Dithal, a naturally beautified village, as a bride. Also, to a socially and prosperous village in every aspects of life. Keep it in mind that mother and motherland are superior to heaven.